Well, hello there, folks. Welcome back to What's For Tea. It's lovely to see you again. And thanks for popping over just to check out this very quick and easy vanilla custard recipe. Now, you can see my spotted dick there just in the corner. And I've just made that. And I will leave the video recipe linked underneath just in case you want to make the two of them together. I was going to do both in the one video, but I asked over in Patreon, or I said over in Patreon, that I might split them up. So this is the custard recipe for those that are just interested in the custard, and it's a beautiful custard. So simple to make and better than anything that you'll find in a tin. I'm going to be using a vanilla pod today, but if you don't have one of these, feel free to use vanilla extract. You'll need 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract if you're not using one of these pods, but I wanted to use one because I've never actually used one before. So all you have to do is split it down the middle and then scrape out the wee seeds inside, and that is your vanilla. So just keep that to the side. But like I said, if you're not using one of these vanilla pods, because they are quite expensive, you know, they're not cheap. I think these were about £6 for the two, and you can buy lots of cans of custard for that. So if you have vanilla extract, you know, you can obviously use that. So get over to your pan, and you want a low to medium heat. We're going to pop in our double cream. I'm using 300 ml, and I'm also going to use some milk as well. This is just whole milk, about 250 ml of whole milk. Just give that a wee stir together, and then you can pop in your vanilla. Now, you just want to simmer this for a few minutes just to, you know, get the flavour of the vanilla out and into your sort of custardy base, if you like. So give that 3 to 5 minutes, just gently simmering away. Then once you're happy, you can grab your sugar. So I've got 3 tablespoons of sugar and 4 free-range egg yolks. Just mix the two of these together really well until they go nice and creamy. Now, if you add this directly into your hot liquid, it'll just scramble. So pop a few tablespoons of your hot liquid into your milk and eggs. Give that a good stir together and then add it to your pan. And that kind of tempers it, you know, so you don't shock your eggs, because you don't want to be left with a scrambled egg or, you know, a very creamy scrambled egg. And then give that a very light whisk, you know, keep whisking away until it's nice and combined, and do let this simmer for a few minutes just to thicken and come together. You'll know your custard is ready when, on the back of your wooden spoon, just draw your finger up, and if it leaves a line, you know, and it doesn't all run, then you know that is ready. So that is absolutely perfect. Now, I'm not going to use this right away. I'm going to use this later on. So I've just transferred mine to a bowl, and I've covered it with cling film. Now, if you make sure that your cling film touches the surface of your custard, you won't get a skin on it. So there's a good wee tip for you. So this was later on. And like I said, we just had some spotted dick, and I will leave the recipe for this in the description box down below. I've done a video on this not that long ago with that lovely vanilla custard on top, but you can see the lovely flecks from the vanilla bean in there, and it's just, oh, a vanilla pod, sorry, and it is just amazing, and it smells incredible. Completely different, you know, to the custard that you get in the can. It's just so much better, and yeah, it's a lot more expensive, a wee bit more effort, but in my opinion, for, you know, just for a one-off, it is well worth it. But just before I leave you and move on, I wanted to say, as usual, a massive thank you to the supporters of the channel over on my Patreon page, and to the channel members here on YouTube as well. So thank you once again, guys, and thanks for watching. In fact, thank you all for watching and leaving your comments, and for those who share the videos, it's very much appreciated. And I'll catch up with you during the week for another wee recipe. And if you're not following me over on Instagram yet, I'm whatsfortea3 over there, and it would be lovely to see you. So keep yourself safe, and I'll catch you off soon back here on What's For Tea. Take care, and bye for now. Bye now.